brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Yes, just a few weeks to witness the killing machine himself, Shafik Chiwanuka. you know me and Faith, behind the scene before we came back on set, we're busy laughing. We're just imagining one time, I remember months ago when we hosted Shafik here, and Shafik told us he's the only one who beats an opponent and does what?
No, he told him I'll box you and then the mouth guard will enter your stomach.
You people have ever seen the mouth guard for boxers?
Yeah.
Now you imagine the killing machine himself hitting you, hitting the Zambian guy. But I hope on the 29th he's going to do that. Remember the
19th.
Fight?
19th.
Not 29th?
19th.
Okay, fine. 19th of this month. The killing machine is actually going to make someone swallow his mouth guard. So we are just waiting for the Zambian guy to meet the country. But our only worry is that I think he has over been hyped. He has been too hyped so much. So we hope the too much hype we've given him in the media won't actually tantamount to his swallowing of the mouth guard.
I think he's a confident young man, so he'll be fine. He'll handle himself well.
So dear Ugandans, come 19th, please, let's all go show support for our own. He's our flag bearer. We have no choice. But, you know, I have so much confidence in him. Being a person who is also very confident, when you see someone, a young person who is confident, that's very kind of good. Now, before we go for the rugby sevens, of course, we all know we are trying to fight to qualify for the Olympics qualifiers. And whoever wins tomorrow, wins between today and tomorrow, yeah? Between tomorrow and the other day, definitely.
Saturday, Sunday.
Yes, Saturday, Sunday. Definitely qualifies to go to Olympics. But our flag bearers in the continent, now, I want to use a political language of flag bearer, because at one point here, people said, you know, when KCCA is at the continent and Proline is at the continent, those are flag bearers of the country, so we need to show them support. Now, these two, actually, me, I was not disappointed by KCCA. I expected the results somehow, because the fact that they failed to get a goal at home, and it was kind of hard.
Even, and look even at, here, looking they at the were team outplayed,
setup,
not so?
Yes, they were outplayed. Mm-hmm. And the team setup itself, you know the Arabs really take football so serious. For us here, Mike Mutebi still thinks our young boys are good to go. Yes, they are young, they are good, but probably we needed some more senior team players too.
You know, for me, if you're looking at Mike Mutebi and his usage of young players, I think his is borderline too much.
Mm-hmm.
And there are moments and days for everything. Like, it's one thing for you to shock people with the lineup that, like, when you're going for the CECAFA Senior Challenge Cup, you can work a Game Cup. You can take all the young kids you want and play around with that tournament.
Mm.
But when you're in the CAF Confederation Cup or CAF Champions League, it's a whole other ball game. Like, you're finding teams that are literally hungrier than you are.
Mm.
Like, these teams have also been in this competition year upon year upon year, and they're not doing anything. So at the end of the day, they also have something to prove. They have points to prove. And you're not going to get someone who's seeing an opportunity to be for his name to go down in shining lights. Yeah? You're not going to get them and think that you're going to just run roughshod. Okay, let me send Alan. Like, look at it this way.
Mm.
It's for me a situation that you can probably, when you look at how, say, as someone like, say, Arsene Wenger handled the young kids at Arsenal. They can only take it to a certain point.
Yes.
They consistently would make sure they finish within the top four. But when push comes to shove, when you throw a Birmingham down their throat, it's not the best teams, by the way, because these teams are struggling.
Why not Wolves?
No, I'm just giving you an
the
example.
The current nightmare.
No, I'm giving you a more palatable example, because now you look at a scenario where a team like Birmingham. They don't look so good. The old Crystal Palaces, they don't look so good on paper. But for some reason, when you have those senior players who just know how to psych themselves, like Troy Deeney and Watford, they will get into a kid's head. And people like if you look at people like Alan Okello, they were like going to be, you know, they're going to be like, a sheep going to a slaughterhouse, literally, because in this scenario, they do not have the experience and the nous to come out of these situations. Yes, they played in many continental, matchups, but you're not going to compare my 3 years of continental football to a man who has played possibly close to 10 years. Like, it is, yes, every time they come close and they're knocked out, but they have more hunger and more determination. And I think even Coach Mike Mutebi going forward in his coaching journey, these are lessons you need to learn. Someone has to smack you in the face sometimes for, reality to sink in.
I think basically, for me, what I would put across about the issue of KCCA before we come about a little bit of pro-line that really actually disappointed me so much. One, the dominance of Uganda at the continent stopped at AC Villa. And no club has, in Uganda has currently upon gone past where AC Villa went. One, two, because even when AC Villa went back to the continent in 2005, you see how they were humiliated, where the likes of Tadeo Luanga reached a point of even telling the referee, "Ref, please can you please send me off the pitch," because it was unbearable. They could not control
2015.
It anymore. 2015.
Yes. I was going to say, Chadeo, how old are you?
2015. I mean, they could not easily contain it anymore. So it clearly tells you that I think for us, Uganda and East Africa at large, because apparently no club in East Africa, because I cannot crucify KCC alone. Even the big teams like Simba FC, Yanga FC, you'd see, are nowhere at the continent. So I think as East African Sekafa region, we need to go back to the drawing board. What is happening with our clubs? How can you help them? Now, having talked about that, by the way, I had a dream that Alan Okello was going to score. And indeed, he scored. You remember, I even posted about it. He scored, but I did not say Alan Okello's score was going automatically making KCCA to go through. No. Mm. Mine was about Alan Okello, and I was happy that my dream came true, and I gave glory to God, because now, Proline, really, honestly speaking, yes, we saw an appreciative word from Mujib Kasule. By the way, I would want to really thank him for that. It is very rare of many sports administrators who come out openly in written to appreciate stakeholders in the country or anywhere for any struggles they've gone through. He's appreciated because you know very well, Proline doesn't have its own fans. The fans who gave him money are the fans of KCCA, Villas, Vipers, and the rest, because they're the continent. Now, what are those challenges that probably you think Proline could have encountered at the continent? Moreover, at home here at Lugogo.
The reality, Sharon, is that Proline came from playing non-league football last year. They were in the big league.
Mm.
So they were definitely going to have issues on the continent. Hook or crook, I think they've done as well as they could to go to this second phase of the CAF Confederations Cup. But the reality was they were just not strong enough.
Mm. And others are blaming it to Matia Lule, but I want to put it categorically. Matia Lule has nothing to be blamed because one is not a permanent coach of Proline. He just went in to help the moment the head coach resigned, went for further studies outside. So that is the state for us as Uganda and East Africa. But I think for Mike Mutebi, I think he got a lesson to learn that much as we are trusting our young players, we've got to mix up the team with some senior players. And of course, as we wind up, the Rugby Cranes take us through.
Of course, the Rugby Cranes will be representing us at the Africa Sevens in South Africa, Cape Town. For the first time, we see in close to 2 years the return of Lawrence Sebuliba. Of course, the team is a little stacked. We have a little bit of the old and the new. We have Ian Munyani, Masa Isa, Kongena Pius, and of course, Aaron Ofoi Roth, Adrian Casito, Aredo Joseph, Levi Sochen, Sebuliba, Lawrence, Odong James, Kevin Keremundu, Philip Okorach, and Michael Okorach. This tournament is going to be almost a double header of sorts. It's going to double as an Olympic qualifier. Winner, straight to the Olympics in Japan. Loser, first runner up will have an opportunity to play a global qualifier. I think it's a huge, huge opportunity for Uganda. It's a huge opportunity.
And which team were we opening with?
It's a huge opportunity for the boys. You now caught me off guard because the producer is telling us.
Because we have quite a number of teams. There's Zimbabwe, there's Kenya, there is South Africa.
They open against Mauritius.
Yes.
That's at 9:44 a.m. That's going to be, a great opportunity. And of course, tomorrow people should not forget that we have also the basketball. The FIBA Africa 3-on-3 basketball tournament starting tomorrow at the hockey pitch in Lugogo. You only need to pay 5,000 and 10,000 and you're in. We've never hosted a 3-on-3. There's a half court built right now. Even if you want to prove, you can pass by there. There's so much. I mean, this weekend is going to be so busy.
All right. I want to thank you so much. Of course, my captivating story, I got to watch. You know, I'm a proud fan of FUFA Big League. I'm going to watch Big League down at Lugo, but at the same time also follow my home team, Paida Black Angels, which is away in Eastern Region, playing against Miadi FC, of course, at Elgon Ground. And we want to wish you the best of your weekend. Please, let's go and support basketball too as we host. Bye-bye. Take care. OneXBet has been a proud sponsor of Sportswoman Show.
Sportswoman is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.